to you. Welcome back to Stephen Hunt. Today, we're going to be taking a slot into CEX, but we're going to not one, but two CEXs in Hull today. And hopefully, they'll trade in this bad boy that I got for £1 recently in a charity shop, because my local CEX couldn't trade this in due to some restrictions with them, strict restrictions with them, the Blu-rays decided to explain. But anyways, other than that then, I got one of them in the car boot recently, and I got this bad boy for like 10 pence. In a charity shop. But yeah, we'll see whatever we can find in the charity shops in Hull, add to the pot. If not, we'll trade whatever in that we can today. So I look forward to hopefully trade all this in. I got quite cheap, so to say.
It's a vlog.
And we're back. So yeah, and just to clarify in general that I'm not much of a reseller. I just find things that just came onto my lap and then chuck into putting CEX on training whatever in is another thing. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen, welcome to Steety Films. It's a vlog, and yeah, I just came back from my hiatus, even though I just had a special vlog because it was my birthday recently, so I do appreciate everyone that enjoyed that. Even though going back to vlogging, I'm trying to do some trips out whilst the rest of the summer and left, and I've been to Hull recently. Because as you may not know, I recently got a certain FIFA game for £1, and they couldn't take it into my local CEX. So I thought this is a good opportunity to go to Hull, and there's two CEXs in Hull. If they don't take it, they actually take it, spoiler alert. But basically, I ended up going to Hull, and we did whatever in Hull, and picked up whatever in Hull. Then it is recording whatever while I was in Hull, I should say, because I'm trying to do some more on about kind of vlogging, I should say. But here's the clip of me while I was in Hull, so roll the VT, I guess.
Despite my selfie fail, I should say.
You were close!
Yes, I'm in Hull. Come past the bridge, and now I'm in Hull. Well, I'm in a quiet bit of an area where I could just walk and talk. Well, and I should be heading to the next CEX because I did my trade-ins and I got whatever in this baggie, I should say. And they traded a lot in, including the certain FIFA game, which is great. So I'm pleased with that. Pleased that they traded that in. The guy was not like looking at what he's traded in. It's like, bish bosh done. So yeah, I'm pleased with that. Didn't need any Blu-ray specific specifications or strict rules on somewhat Blu-rays. Oh, there's a trash shut down there. Anyways, but yeah, we'll head this way. Then he's heading wherever, because I'm kind of, I'm not saying lost is the word. I've got Google Maps in hand. It's just a bit wary because it's been like since 2019 I last been to Hull, and it was just finding my way around, I should say, to get to places. Than it is going, sorry for the noise there, but yeah, anyways, yeah, you get what I mean. So it's just finding my way around again, hopefully find my way around to certain shops. Even though I'm walking past quite a few charity shops, it's another thing, but anyways, you get what I mean. So there's loads of particular shops to have a browse, see what they got, then they're seeing what they got in the CEXs and cash converters. I've been to one cash converters, but I heard there's another cash converters. There's two cash converters, funny of which. So I need to find that. There's find my way around, even though that, I'm in Hull, having a nice day in Hull. Was a bit sceptical at first, but I'm all right in terms of travelling, etc. So yeah, just finding my way around, like I said, just seeing all the sightseeing, and it is whatever, I should say, that's in Hull. But I just stepped in a puddle kind of thing. I think I recognise this area. I think I'm in the right area, I should say, that it is somewhat sightseeing, and somewhat buildings, etc. But yeah, other than that then, just in Hull, browsing through Hull. But I think it's that way the next CEX is. But yeah, I'm looking forward to picking whatever on my travels.
So yeah, and that was my clip in a nutshell, despite going out and about. And yeah, I had a really nice time in Hull. I should say. A bit wary, but the travelling was good and all that. So I would like to go again now, but it depends on what they have in stock, I should say. Because of it, I just looked up on the internet, thanks internet, by their website, and just looked on their website and see what they have in stock. Because I can always go again, even though it's like an hour-ish trip on the bus, I should say. But I will go there again, hopefully. That is, whatever I trade in is another thing. And which, speaking about trade-ins, I thought I'd quickly clarify in terms of what I actually traded in before I show you the pickups that I picked up. And basically, I did stumble across some 50 pence games in the car boots last Sunday. I ended up getting Modern Warfare 2 and Call of Duty Black Ops 2. And you know, Call of Duty Black Ops 2 is going for quite a bit at the moment, even though I do have multiple copies of it. Because I actually have the 50 pence copy that I just got, and I've got a very scratched one that I got from Cash Converters one time. Then I got the variant where it's basically the Xbox One casing and all that. So they go for quite a bit now, Call of Duty Black Ops 2. So I was very lucky enough to get a copy for 50 pence from the car boot. Now, do keep in mind, I don't do reselling and all that, but if you find something quite cheap, then go for it, because I managed to make a blooming stack in general of them certain games, and then chuck it to CX is another thing. But yeah, I was really pleased to get that, and I was very lucky of which to get a certain game from a charity shop for 10 pence. And I just like recorded whatever and then send it to my friend Cruel Lord Soft. And this is the clip that I sent to Cruel Lord Soft, and is I had to edit a bit of it because I misled on certain things when realising afterwards when I sent him that clip, if that makes sense. So here's a minor clip of it. I don't think you can see it, but I can see it. But basically, yeah, there is quite a number of scratches. So rather not risking taking this copy into CEX, I was just about to say. But before saying that and finishing off this clip, I realised that this is the complete edition with the K. Now, I didn't realise this until I put it on my Xbox One, because of it. I thought, oh, why not test it out either way, because I switched out the discs either way, and basically, even if it does read the part of the disc that is the licensed part of the disc, it just works, and doesn't matter if it's scratched or laser burns or whatever. I did a video about it before, so it's good thing I kept it, switched it out, than it is in keeping it. I'd rather have the complete edition than a normal edition. My theory is this must have been originally in CEX, and basically they must have got the wrong disc, so I'm happy to have the complete edition, I should say, into CEX. So we're going to switch it out with this copy, because this is the one I got at launch, as you can see by the price, then is the one I got here for 10 pence. 10 whole pence! And so, yeah, because if I recall, because I got this at launch, because I keep this in really good condition, well, it would do. So, yeah, I ended up getting that for 10 pence, despite I didn't realise it was the collector's edition with a K. And I'll keep that in my collection, and they end up taking that into CEX, and then is switching out the copies I have to make sure it's better than nothing, at least. For trading, because of, you know, I do tend to swap out whatever discs, etc., just to make it clean enough. But again, no, it's just that when I took into Hull, he didn't even bat an eye on, you know, like say FIFA 19 or anything like that. So other than that, though, I'm actually pleased with the pickups I got in Hull, then he's trading whatever in for cheap towards these things that I end up getting. Now, first of which, as you may not notice, despite my 30 pounds Apple Watch that I got, I actually got this really nice sports loop. I think it's called sports loop or whatever it's called. And I got that for £10. And it's unboxed though, sadly, because they tend to sell whatever that's unboxed. And then is this one that I got a boxed version, which I haven't even opened yet, but I thought I was going to show you because I haven't even opened yet. Because this is a sports loop, right? This is the grey and black one. Well, it's actually called whatever Apple likes to call whatever that is. I don't think you can see that, sorry. Yeah, hold on, focus. Try and focus, but it's Tornado Grey and Tornado Grey Sports Loop. So yeah, it's a Tornado Grey, whatever it's called. And this is weather, because you have to be aware of them, which, because I'm a 38mm, and it does say, basically 38mm, and this is a grade A, because this hasn't been opened, so it's got the little, thingy-ma-bob where you open it and all that. I'm not going to keep it in this box, don't worry. I will utilise this as soon as the summer is over, because this is quite summery. Even my mum said this is quite summery, this band is. Because of Apple Watch straps are quite hard to find, even in the 38mm one. I did see some in the car bids, but the guy was like, no, these are for the bigger ones, for around the 42-ish ones or 48. So luckily I didn't buy that, and then the game web in the CEX is in Hull. Then it is some other things I got in the CEX in Hull, and I got Bubba. Yeah, even though the original price, as you can see, no, don't worry, that's not the CEX price. This is from the old game price, from the old... you may not know what game is. It's basically a UK store that we have. And basically, this costs whatever, and it still had the original stickers in it. I can quickly show you this bike. This used to originally cost about £20, but it was reduced to 10, because knowing CEX, they tend to change the price now and again. And I got this for a really good price of £10. And as you can see, the bottom is a bit beat up, but I tried to fix it though with some good old sticky tape and all that. So I managed to fix whatever that I can on that. So yeah, it's a nice box. I don't think I'm going to display it though. I've got too many like wee stuff there, as you can see. And it's hard to display things nowadays in my room. But I'll keep it somewhere in a good place. And I don't think I'm ever going to play it. Not saying play it. I did play it on the stream. And we had a right old giggle. Here's a minor clip of it. Look, you want me to drink my red bean for Pete's sake? I tried it. Multitasking, yeah? Here, have some red bean. Here, drink the red bean. Drink the red bean. But yeah, other than that then, we had a right laugh, and Krylosoft said, you gotta stream it, you gotta stream it, and all that. So I had fun either way, streaming that. Then there's some other things I picked up that are Nintendo related. I picked up this Amiibo, because I was after this Amiibo for quite a while, because as you may recall, I ended up getting the Inkling, which is the Orange Inkling, which is this one, but it was a different variant. It was the Smash Bros. One that I got quite cheapish on Amazon, boxed. So I traded that in, and then again, if it weren't for that, I would not have gotten the Diablo Amiibo that's in its box, as you can see up there. And now I finally got this in my collection that I was wanting for quite some time. But the funny thing is, though, I noticed it has like a bit of a... I'm saying a bald patch, but I mean, there's a bit of a line there, as you can see. There's a bit of a line there. I don't know if that's a manufacturing error, or maybe it's just how it is. I haven't seen much unboxings of it, but yeah, I noticed it's a bit dirty, is another thing. Anyways, but yeah, you can see what I mean. It is quite a nice figure, nonetheless. It'll go nicely with my Amiibo collection, because I wanted this for quite a while. Which, by the way, I got this for £10, which is not bad buy. Despite getting one of the Amiibos they have in. Now, the other Nintendo-related stuff that I've got, because as you may recall, that when I went to Scunthorpe, and I was going to go and get a certain GameCube game, an underrated gem, I should say, for the GameCube, and that is Billy Hatcher and the Giant Egg. Oh, Billy. Yes, I got this finally, because originally I was going to get this in Scunthorpe, but they didn't have it in. And it is, complete in box as well, which is quite nice. And yeah, I got it for £10. Again, it's an underrated game. I used to have this in my collection, but I must have got rid of it for some reason. I don't know why. And I should not have. Stupid me. And yeah, I just now I got it back in my collection, which is nice. So yeah, an underrated GameCube game that most people should try out, at least, in their GameCube collection. Then here's Xbox Original Games. I end up picking this for a good price, and they go for weather on Amazon, and luckily I got this for quite cheap because they recently lowered the price down for this game, and it is complete in box, but sadly though, there's a receipt in here that I'm trying not to show you, but it is complete in box, as you can see, look, it is complete in box, and Just the disc doesn't kind of work for some reason on one of my Xbox originals. I have two Xbox original consoles. I'm sure it will work with one upstairs, despite the disc is a bit scratched up. But either way, jobs are good, and at least I got that in my collection is another thing. Because I've been like buying like quite a number of Xbox original games lately. Even though they're quite cheap, I managed to get whatever. And just accumulate a load of Xbox original games, which is quite nice. Because of, you know, knowing me, I was a Nintendo fanboy when I first started. And now grown out of my shell with the Nintendo stuff. And, you know, I have one in my collection, I should say. And, yeah, it's just nice to play Xbox original games now and again. That most people don't get on GameCube is another thing. Anyways, then it is the Nintendo 64. I ended up getting like a box copy, a really nice box copy of Perfect Dark. Now, as you can see by the little, there's little nip bits on the ears that I can easily snip off if I wanted to. Should I snip it off? I don't know. Anyways, but yeah, there was like a minor bump on the top, but I'm trying to fix it by opening it up and fix the bump a bit, but I ended up getting this for like £20, as you can see, nice box copy of Perfect Dark. I was going to get Harry Potter on the Game Boy Color, but the box was a bit naff, and it has like packaging tape on all that. I was like, nah, I'd rather not get that. So yeah, I ended up getting this, which was quite nice to add to my collection. Despite, I try to not go for the, you know, the box, but if they're cheap, they're cheap. I mean, like, because I do like the artwork of Perfect Dark, as you can see right there. And finally, the next thing that I got that I wanted for quite some time, and they had one in stock in the CX in Hull, and that is a Nintendo. As you can see right here, it's an official 2DS case, which you fit your 2DS. You know, I recently got a 2DS quite some months ago, and this is a really nice 2DS case. And as you can see, you can fit like certain cartridges in here up to three, which is nice, which is cool. So yeah, it's a nice case overall, and yeah, it was just nice to nab that for like £4, which is good. But other than that though, despite getting weather for cheap and trading and whatever, I'm actually pleased I got weather in Hull. And yeah, other than that then, what I've been up to lately is another thing. I've been all right. It's just that time I've been like sorting out whatever. By that I mean just doing whatever for the upcoming vlogs. Then it's doing whatever trips, because I'm planning to go to Immingham next week. Hopefully, fingers crossed. Well, I might have to go twice because I got a dentist appointment next Friday. So I have to do whatever next Friday. Then do whatever, and then go to the dentist next Friday. So hopefully, fingers crossed, I get that vlog uploaded next Friday. And then it is planning to go to Immingham because of I saw a certain controller that I might get, and that is a certain Xbox Series S controller, because I only got two white ones. Well, one of the white ones is a bit naff. But other than that, then it would be nice to add this to my collection. By that I mean this variant, which I think is a I was gonna say a Xbox Labs one that someone made, and it's like, nah, I don't like it, I'd rather sell it, you know. So it's a good price even than the original Vault yellow like one. I think it's a unique colour with the camo on it, because I try to not have too many camo ones, because I have like other Xbox 360, Xbox One controls, like this camo, for example, the original, and I have for my original Xbox. But I plan to do something, speaking of which, with my original Xbox One console, the Phantom one, you know, the fat one that's in 2013 one. I'm planning to do a specific video with that, once Starfield has came, been and gone. But I hope you guys are enjoying Starfield, you lucky people that get to play early is another thing. And hopefully I will, I've just been like out and about and just been doing whatever. I've been lacking on playing whatever. I've been trying to play a bit of Destiny 2 again, then doing whatever since before and after my birthday. And then it's saying not whatever because of it. I've been buying whatever, and lately, you may have saw my social media, has been buying whatever because I had whatever cash left since after being to Hull. And lately, after that, buying whatever, it's just, you know, trying not to splurge on them too many things. Because I recently had to pay the bill, the gas ban bill, and luckily the gas, well, it's most electricity that I'm mostly using. And luckily I don't have to spend a heap load because of the gas bills, for gas I'm referring to. That it is other things I'm trying not splurge and buying because of crew loads off. I should really focus on a certain thing, I should say. But other than that though, we'll leave that on for another time. I'll mention whatever my next vlog, depends on it. But it's hard to explain whatever since been on the hiatus, even though I had my birthday recently and all that. But I've been hunky-dory, I've been going out and out and a bit more and more whenever I can. And yeah, just looking forward to hopefully going to Immingham next week on the bus, get that Xbox One control, well, Xbox Series S control, Xbox Series controller, I should say, and then maybe nip in a few charity shops. There's only a few charity shops down there. Depends on if I ever do get that controller. If not, I'll still make a trip there because I got a blooming dentist appointment. It's all different thing. Depends on how I'm gonna do the vlog. There's another thing next Friday. Anyways, I'm going off topic, and I'm really going to tangent now. So that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying this vlog, watching and understanding. Didn't forget to follow up on my social medias of what I'm up to. Anyways, I'll let you guys get on with your day. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steety Films.